The new inflation numbers for August showed that headline and underlying inflation both went down substantially. Headline inflation went down from 3.5% to 2.7%. This is less than half the 6.1% we inherited, and it's now less than a third of its peak. Trimmed mean inflation went down from 3.8% to 3.4%. That is the lowest in more than 30 months. If you exclude volatile items, it went down from 3.7 to 3. Non-tradable inflation, which is what others call homegrown inflation, went down from 4.5% to 3.8%. And services inflation went down as well. These are very welcome, very encouraging, and very heartening numbers. We expected headline inflation to come down. We've also seen underlying inflation come down considerably as well, and that's a very good thing. Our policies are a factor here, but they're not the only factor. If you look at rents, they went up 6.8% in the year to August, but without our increases to rent assistance, they would have increased by 8.6%. Electricity prices fell 17.9% in the year to August, but without the energy rebates, they would have decreased 2.7%. But the story here goes beyond the government's policies, which are helping in the fight against inflation. Whether it's rent, whether it's energy rebates, our cost of living policies are an important part of the story, but they're not the whole story here. We're seeing right across a number of measures of inflation, including underlying inflation, that it has come off considerably in the new numbers that we see today. So these are heartening numbers, encouraging numbers, they're welcome numbers, but we're not getting carried away because we know that the monthly numbers can be volatile. We know that inflation doesn't always moderate in a straight line, and we know that people are still under pressure. And that's why our cost of living help is so important, and it's also why our responsible economic management is so important. And Katie's going to say a few things about that.
Thanks very much, Jim, and it's lovely to be here in your home city today.
You're always welcome here.
It's glorious to be here. But thanks, Jim. So what we've seen is our responsible economic management is helping in the fight against inflation, seen in those numbers today. And that budget management, particularly about returning revenue to the budget, finding savings in the budget and reprioritising spending, has helped us with our budget improvements that we're seeing. And on Monday, we'll be releasing the final budget outcome. That'll show our second surplus, and it'll be an improvement on the number that we released during the budget. And that improvement in the budget outcome is not related to increased revenue, but is related to less spending on the spending side of the budget. And we know from the comments that the RBA governor has made in the past that surplus budgeting is helping in the fight against inflation, that is a big help. And you'll see that reflected in the budget outcome, the FBO that we do on Monday. But that's really our approach to budgeting, Jim and mine, to find savings, return revenue, deliver budget surpluses when the inflation challenge has been what it has. And that's helping overall in that fight against inflation.